Hi traders, this is Forex Nelson and I'm back again today with another 9 trades. Today's date is August the 16th and I'm using my new FX trigger system. Most of these trades, except for I believe one, they were all a great way to trade, except this first one that I sold, the pound Aussie. I traded it the way I teach in the videos called How to Trade Pullbacks. In other words, when it's far enough away from the goal line, that's a pullback. Now, keep in mind, whoever buys the FX trigger, I will be showing you how you can get your hands on this trading simulator for the MT4 platform. This is a totally free app, and I highly recommend you get it. As with myself, after a few weeks of practicing with it, I was able to double my pip totals. I used to be happy with 40 or 50 pips, and then I was getting around 80 to 100, and now many days I'm getting around the 200. So then that's all a directly result of using this trading simulator every weekend when the market is closed for up to 8 hours. You can put in many trades running at a time. Keep in mind that they do give you a $10,000, starts here at $10,000. And then you can do hedging, you can buy, you can sell multiple orders, you can do stacking. It does come with a 25-page ebook that teaches you how to work all the different options and features that it has to offer. And now before we get into these trades, I would like to inform you that all trading systems will work less than 50% of the time, and that includes all my trigger systems. Now it took me 8 years and over 700 systems to learn that. I always used to complain, doesn't anybody sell something that has a higher success rate? Now, if you really want to get that up to 80 or 90% success rate, you will have to learn how to trade the flow of the market, which is what I teach. You will also have to learn trade management and money management. To be successful in trading, all you need is a lot of chart time, a lot of demo trading, and a lot of education. I provide the education. You must buy this education because the free stuff on the internet is no good. And then after you get the education, you must do the homework or you will fail at trading. I highly suggest putting in more than one trade at a time, as no one knows which pair will move the greatest number of pips. That is why I place 3 or more trades at a time. Also, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to my YouTube channel. This will encourage me to do more of these videos. If you leave your name and email address, I'll put you on my email list for free weekly trading tips. Now we can get into these trades. Now the first thing I saw on this pound Aussie that looks like we're buying, but it was too far away from the goal line, and I knew I just wanted to grab a few pips. In other words, the pullback. So here we go, drag and drop this up. Exactly what I said, there's my stop up there, and I was only grabbing a few pips. And my idea of closing out the trades is once I get 100 or more pips, I generally start thinking about closing out the trades. But today I did 3 future pairs. And lately I've been trading futures because they pump out more pips. And moving forward, I'm going to be focusing on these 4. Oil, gold, S&P 500, and the 30-year treasury bonds. So this was the pullback. Stop was only 22, and I closed it out with looks like 5, and 5 pips on the pound Aussie trade paid $439. Moving along to the next trade, pound New Zealand. Here we go. This one I also did the pullback as it was coming down. Got in a little bit late. It did one more little cycle here. Not a big deal. I knew I was only in the trade for very few pips. And I took the trade at this cursor, did go against me 12 pips, and I closed it out with 7 pips. Just being happy, remember that. When you're happy, close the trade. What did I say? Around 7 pips. And those 7 pips on the pound New Zealand paid $491. Moving on to the next trade, Euro CAD. This one I bought and I was going in the direction of the FX trigger. As you can see from way back when, don't even know how far back it went. Way back here, I was getting a buy signal. So that's what I bought or did. There was the pullback, but I didn't catch it or see it till over here, as I was definitely preoccupied with things going on around the house. But I took the trade, and as you can clearly see, if I stayed in the trade, I would have done even much better. But when I did finally decide to close out the trades, right around between 9 and, well, let's see what time that was. Close out the trades, approaching around 10. I try to close out my trades between 9 and 10, so I got the rest of the day to do as I please. I ended up closing it out with this trade was 7 pips, and 7 pips on the EuroCAD paid $557. Also, keep in mind, if you're the type of trader who would like to get more pips, like that's 33 pips, I have 2 excellent videos that I teach how to stay in the trade for more pips, as I still don't have a sell signal down at the bottom. Moving right along to the next trade, dollar CAD, another one I bought. System was saying to buy from back here. Took a trade on this bit of a pullback here to the moving average, and I closed it out just being happy with 11 pips, and 11 pips on the dollar CAD paid $875. Moving right along to a futures pair, the 30-year treasury bonds. System was saying to buy. I bought it. Let's see where I got in at. Again, ideally would have been down here, but can only take the trade when I actually spot it. And I spotted it right at this point, close it out being happy. Looks like with about 46. And those 46 pips paid out $2,200. Moving on to the next trade, pound Swiss. This one I sold it. The system was saying to sell. Lots of red boxes. And by the way, most of these trades did qualify for a great way to trade. That is using the moving averages on the top and the indicators down at the bottom. So late to the party, but that's okay. I knew it was going to drop. And keep in mind, the reason why I know it's going to drop is because I'm going in the direction of the higher time frames. I do teach that within the training videos. Ended up closing out the trade, looks like with 26 pips. And 26 pips on the pound Swiss paid $2,852. Moving on to the next trade, which is the pound yen. Another one I sold. Another one that qualified for a great way to trade. FX trigger was saying to sell. The red lines, the red boxes, there's my stop there. Took the trade, stop was 9 pips, and I closed it out being happy with 40. And 40 pips on the pound yen paid $3,665. Moving on to the last two pairs are actually futures, and this is oil. Let's go and check oil, see where I got in at. Did qualify for a great way to trade when I pulled the trigger. And by the way, this is a flag pattern. I recognized it being a flag pattern, and I was 95% sure that it was going to give me another cycle. And when you're 95% sure, then you don't really mind taking a trade. Stop in real time. I don't quite see where the stop is, but in real time it would have been there. And of course, I close it out being happy with 40. Looks like 40 pips, 39 to 40. And those pips paid $3,900. Moving on to the last instrument, which is the S&P 500. Let's run a check on that. Drag and drop it up. Another one did qualify for a great way to trade. Everything is screaming red, the boxes, the system. So this is what I would label as perfect timing entry. Did not even go one pip against me. There's my stop right there. Look at how tight it was. You traders who want to trade with a small stop, that's only 13. It's pretty small, especially for the S&P 500. And I close it out, as I said, many, many times when I'm happy. And I definitely was happy with 100 and 122. That's 12 points, by the way. 12 points or 122. And those 122 pips paid $6,125. Keep in mind that the S&P 500, each point you get paid $50. So just so that you brings clarity, let's go with 12 points, and 12 times $50 is roughly, it's like divided by 2, that's 6, so $6,125. So another excellent trading day to start off the week. Ended up with 304 pips and ticks. Remember the futures, they call it ticks, but it's on the MT4 platform, so doesn't really make any difference, pips or ticks. And 304 pips ended up paying out $21,105. So if your system is not producing on a daily basis like my FX trigger system, I suggest you get your hands on it. To do so, all you have to do is look right below this video and you'll see this write-up. My FX trigger system, I do charge $250 for it. I teach how to trade the flow of the market. This system comes with well over 4 GB of training, and you'll get an exact copy of my system on your MT4 platform. Now it comes with 5 MT4 templates, 12 custom indicators, and my favorite meter. I threw in a lot of PDF books, a lot of Word documents, and 9 bonus videos. This is what you're going to need. A lot of education to succeed. Now there's 43 training videos, and one of them that I included is in red here, how to backtest using the trading simulator. It's about 50 minutes long, packed with a lot of trade examples and tips and tricks. Now there's a lot of ways to trade. My number one way of trading is a great way to trade. You can put the video on pause, read all the different ways that I teach. If you have any questions at all, quite simple, pick up the phone and call me. Here's the number. If you live too far, just shoot me an email. Here's my email address. Remember, there's an underscore right here. I do prefer Skype. Simple. All you got to do is click on the link. We'll have Skype connection, and through Skype screen sharing, I will give you a free session and answer your questions. Keep in mind that there's no obligation to you. Now, if you click on this link right here, you'll see 34 screenshots of all the trigger systems I've been building over the years. So that just about wraps up this video, and I'll repeat it one more time. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to my YouTube channel. So until the next trade, happy trading, and remember to keep yourself and your family safe. Okay, bye for now.